Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make different cards with a Tim Holtz Blank Bix die, one of my favorite sort of dies. They can cut lots of different materials, a chipboard being one of them, which is perfect as I love texture and saves a lot of time gluing layers together, and I show you how you can use it in 5 different ways with 7 card ideas. For the first card, I cut blanks out of watercolor card and I spray some water, and then I'm going to start adding color with the Acrafo pens. These pigmented watercolor pens come in sets of 3, and I used pens from different sets, but you can use just one set and get gorgeous results too. I added the main products I used in the description box for you, and you can find the full list of supplies and the different Acrafo sets on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And when you do so, you may like to click the little notification bell so you don't miss a thing. I just keep layering some colors to get texture and a bit of color difference to create some interest. The Acrafo ink spreads in the water I sprayed, and you can always spray more water if needed. I find this coloring very relaxing and fun to do, and you get pretty results real fast. And these already make a great base for a card, and just let it dry or use a heat tool. Now for the first color I used the smaller blanks only, and I have another set of Acrafo pens, a surprise party, and for the blanks I used the wider ones. Now this is a new set, and I start with squeezing them to get the ink down to the tip. I let some ink come out, but you don't have to. If you start with the pens, you can squeeze it lightly, so just the tip colors, and then start using it. And it's a pretty bold color mix, but it will work mixed with the right colors, and the color gets a bit softer when it's dry. I blot the planks and let them dry. I start to assemble the card with the first planks I made. I just lay them out. I lay them out so they fit, and then I add them to the card. I cut off the parts that are sticking out, and I add them back on the card to fill the open spaces. And this is the card base. I did the same with the big planks. And these are the cards I made with the colored planks. I made a frame around the first card and combined it with a glitter flower, and the bright colors in the background combined with the dark blue. For the second technique, I use expanding mousse, and I apply it with a Nuvo Media spatula. And this is a great tool. It's easy to hold and perfect for paper crafting projects. I turn the blanks around to apply it in all directions. You can use a watercolor card too, as this has a bit more bite, so the mousse will spread easier. and then I used the heat tool to expand the mousse. This is the card I made with it, with some gorgeous texture and very easy to do, and I added a glitter sentiment with the green word from Paper Colored with the same mousse. For the third technique, I use an embossing folder, the lumber, which goes perfect with the planks, and it gives a very detailed wood grain. I apply embellishment mousse with a sponge. I just rub it on, not too much, on parts filling the creases, and leave some white here and there. And then I apply the next color on a piece of paper, and then I close the pot again so it doesn't dry out. And you don't have to put your finger in it, which I've heard can cause mold. I've never had that happen, but it doesn't hurt to be on the safe side. I pick up a bit with my finger and rub it on the paper and then rub it on the planks. This way there's not too much product on my finger and I don't fill up the creases. Depending on which color you like best, you can start with the darker color and the lighter for the top color. Now look at the gorgeous shine you get, and this is the finished card I made with the planks. I love how the embossing folder adds to the texture. I cut a big tattered flowers out of a vintage music paper and some glitter for the sentiment again on black this time. For the next technique, I colored a watercolor paper with Acrylfaux pens and embossed the planks, and now I'm going to make a weave pattern. I tape the planks together and I keep the weave on one side to create a fun look. And this is the card base. I will show you the finished card in a bit. I colored the planks with Distress Oxide ink on watercolor paper, and I cut the same planks out of ultra smooth card. I taped it to the back of the walnut stained planks. I weave the planks and make sure they are turned, so they look different with different patterns next to each other. If you want more color on your card, you can also work with a colored background. I colored it with Distress Oxide spray, and by adding white to the back of the planks, they will stand out a bit more. And these are the finished cards with the glitter flower and the texture from the embossing folder. You can add a sentiment or leave it like this. And the other card with some flowers and the texture from the watercolor card and Distress Oxide ink. And for the last card, I cut the planks out of glitter card, and this comes with a gorgeous texture. The color changes a bit depending on the light, and I just add the planks on the black card. I filled up the sides with the smaller pieces and I tape the card to a white note card. I added a colorful sentiment with the same colors Acrylfaux from one of the first cards, and this is just a simple and fast card. Always good to have fast and simple ideas at hand, right? I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting!